one or the other. I'm in English, maybe I can hand out for you. We are gathered here because we care for the North Korean people. We have come here because we refuse to remain silent while innocent North Korean people are beaten, tortured, and sent to concentration camps where they endure unimaginable brutalities. Many of them are publicly executed in front of the crowd, including their children and neighbors. Obviously, beating, torturing, and killing people don't occur in secrecy. In fact, these constitute the demonstrated and educational method of sustaining the regime's power. And yet, risking all the dangers of being caught and punished, countless people have been running away from their prison country into China, some to avoid the persecution, and others to find refuge from starvation or to gain food for their relatives who have nothing to eat. But when the North Koreans have fled the world's worst dictatorship, they have only arrived at new kinds of misery, sexual exploitation, forced marriage, fugitive life to avoid detection, mistreatment by Chinese police or court, and overall, forced repatriation literally by hundreds every week back to North Korea, where they face brutal punishment, often including death. Recently, there are reports of new creative methods of stopping the flow of refugees. In one instance, seven refugees who had crossed the Yalu River to China near Hesan, Yangang province, were chased down by North Korean security police. The police shot to death five of them, and injured two, and dragged both the dead and injured back to North Korea in acquiescence of Chinese authorities. North Korean guards attacking refugees after they are already in China is unprecedented. It is a new pattern under Kim Jong-un's enhanced measure to prevent the exodus to freedom. Also, several cases have been reported recently about the South Korean missionaries who have suffered a sudden death in parts of China near North Korea. This is what you have briefly described. These human rights activists were helping North Korean refugees, advising them about escape from China, or teaching them Bible. Each of these missionaries who had no previous health problem collapsed dead suddenly. Reliable sources have reported intense suspicion that these activists were poisoned by members of North Korea's dreaded Reconnaissance General Bureau. In Korean, it is Dongchal-chungguk. However, the Chinese authorities, in keeping with the policy of coddling North Korean regime, are prohibiting the investigation, including an autopsy. In protest against China's handling of North Korean refugees, many governments and human rights activists and organizations have often demanded that if China doesn't want those North Korean refugees, then China must allow them to go to other countries, such as South Korea and the United States. That would be happy to accept them. But China forcibly deported the arrested refugees only to their prison homeland, knowing well that they will meet death or, if lucky, hellish life. China's forced repatriation policy, along with its protection of North Korean crimes inside China, leads to the conclusion that while North Korea is the world's worst criminal state, China is an accomplice in the crime. In conclusion, the Chinese government must change. It must behave worthy of the teaching nation in the name of the great people of China, for the sake of a better world and for the sake of humanity. China must stop its cruel policy now. If the world's second most powerful nation continues to serve North Korea as a criminal accomplice, it spells sad news for the future of the world. Therefore, all of us here, all of those who are protesting against China in 26 cities and 13 countries at this very moment, and all the freedom-loving peoples of the world, including President Lee Myung-bak, President Obama, and UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon, must continue pressing Chinese leaders to live up to their conscience, abide by their international treaty obligations to protect human lives, and act like the responsible players of the world community. We shall not rest until China stops its inhuman policies. Thank you very much.
Our next speaker is with Jubilee Campaign, one of our coalition members. If it hadn't been for the Jubilee Campaign's help, we never would have had this many countries involved. And so we're so grateful for their support on this protest. It's my honor to hear this great speech from the Jubilee Campaign.
Thank you, Suzanne, for introducing. As Jubilee Campaign's representative of many other NGOs that work together in the North Korean Freedom Coalition that come together to help us with this protest, I am honored to be here to add my voice to the chorus of protests both here and around the world. In dozens of cities, 26 now, I am honored, but I'm also compelled to join this protest. We are all compelled because the fate of the North Korean refugees demands protest. As Peter Kang discussed, and as the defector will tell you, for those who flee from North Korea to China suffer a multitude of torments without any hope of legal redress because China's secret agreement with North Korea turns justice on its head. Instead of punishing human traffickers and criminals, the North Korean victims suffer brutal imprisonment and then are repatriated and face torture and death. Chinese actions clearly violate the pledge they made to protect refugees by signing the UN Convention relating to the status of refugees and its optional protocol. Let me emphasize, though, that we are not merely protesting China and its vicious treatment of refugees. We are protesting the brutal regime that forced countless thousands of North Koreans to flee in the first place. We are here protesting in front of the Chinese embassy because they aid and abet North Korea's human rights abuses. We are here because by supporting North Korea, China has become an accomplice in crimes against humanity. Conditions in North Korea are really like scenes from nightmares. North Korea replaces freedom of the press with a constant barrage of state propaganda, a universal environment of fear where families and friends report on each other's ideological purity that replaces freedom of speech. Freedom of movement, the oldest definition of liberty, does not exist. And religious belief of any kind or creed, save for the worship of the Kim family, is a crime against the state. Government mass management and Kim family's obsession with nuclear weapons cause shortages and famines. And when those famines mean that there is not enough food, they simply deny rations to unproductive members of society, like women, children, and the elderly. North Korea denies its people rights fundamental to civilization. In some ways, people in North Korea do not possess legal rights, for their very lives could be taken at the whim of a government official or the rumor of a denouncing witness. In many cases, torture and execution take place without any kind of trial or legal proceeding, to say nothing of genuine due process in respect to the rule of law. Those not summarily executed are sentenced to concentration camps, to torture, experimented on, or simply worked to death. The men and women in these camps become crippled in body and mind. They become barely recognizable as human beings in the guards treated like beasts. In fact, the official policy of North Korea prohibits sexual contact with political prisoners because that would acknowledge their basic humanity. And humanity is something the government of North Korea is not prepared to give them. Innocent children born in these camps are sentenced by North Korea's guilt by association laws, experience the same treatment with virtually no chance of release. And we must remember that these horrors are carried out, are being carried out on a genocidal scale, and the victims number in the millions. For too long, the international community has ignored the crimes inflicted on the people of North Korea. Earlier this month, there was a coalition in Tokyo, which is one of the cities that joined in our protest, calling for a UN Commission of Inquiry to investigate North Korea for crimes against humanity. While North Korea remains one of the most closed and secretive countries in the world, the testimony of thousands of North Korean refugees and defectors like Will Beery and Pitt has established the truth. And this is the truth. The policies of the government of North Korea are nothing less than crimes against humanity, and those who plan, order, and carry them out are barbarians. So I ask the government of China, why do you partner with barbarians? Why do you shield and enable this rogue state? Among the many crimes committed by the North Korean government, they have a vicious policy of racial superiority, which particularly targets those of ethnic Chinese descent. Why do you defend and enable an ideology that explicitly views the Chinese people as subhuman? I want to make the choice clear for the Chinese government. There are two paths in front of the People's Republic of China. On the one hand, there is the path of progress, of trade, of presence, and prominence in the international community. There are the statements that China has made concerning human rights, the covenants China has joined of its own free will. This path leads to prosperity, peace, and the respect of the world community as China lives up to its potential as a leader in world affairs. On the other hand, is a path of deceit, of secret agreements in violation of international treaties. In this path, China wastes its influence, protecting a rogue state which despises the Chinese people. This path marginalizes China as it continues to pursue an outdated Cold War-era foreign policy in a time when globalization makes these tactics obsolete. This path leads to suspicion, division, and protests which shame China in front of the world. China can choose to respect its covenants and embrace its position in the international community, or it can choose to cower in the shadows of a rogue state that receives no respect because it deserves none. We are here, on this day, in this city and around the world, to send a message to the government of China. Two paths are in front of you, and the time to choose is now.
Thank you. It's my great honor to introduce one of the leading lights in the defector community, one of the most active North Korean defectors who came here from South Korea. He's the director of Free North Korea Radio and also one of the founders of the North Korea People's Liberation Tribe. He's my little brother, Kim Sung-min.
It's good to be back in Washington, D.C. to see all of you people again. And yesterday in Seoul, 50 members of the People's Liberation Front and other defectors came in front of the Chinese embassy in Seoul and held a protest demonstration in conjunction with the events that are going on this week. And that's happening in 26 countries and 13 cities. And they delivered a petition as well in Seoul. And this was happening yesterday.
한국자들을 위한 그 추산설 투입, 그리고 미국의 그 미국 행사들, 그리고 남한의 대국 행사들, 탈북자들을 위해서 해마다 이런 생태상 같은 이런 시대를 벌이고 있는 데서 탈북자의 한 사람으로서 진심으로 되는 동의하기 감사합니다.
As a North Korean defector, I give my deepest appreciation and respect to Suzanne and to other human rights fighters and patriots who gather each year, every year, without fail, and protest in front of the Chinese embassy. So I deeply thank everyone here for coming and participating.
먼저 우리는 이 사진을 좀 잠깐 주목할 필요가 있다고 봅니다. 신솔 씨의 여성형이 7년 전에 중국에서 우리를 남남을 인정해달라라고 수상사를 이렇게 집에서 썼고요. 이걸 들고 중국 외교부 앞에서 시위를 하다가 중국 공안이 무자비하게 체포해서 북한을 강제 북송했고 그 이듬해 총살당했다는 소식이 한국으로 전해졌습니다. 이런 사람들을 위해서 우리가 지금 이 자리에 서 있다고 생각합니다.
Please look at the picture to my right, the Wofa 7. These are seven North Korean refugees who were in China who actually wrote the sign, please recognize us as refugees. And they wrote the sign and they went to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in China, in Beijing, to protest. And they were immediately arrested and forcibly repatriated. And we have good information to tell us that they were executed in North Korea. We are here for these people. This is the reason why we are gathered this afternoon.
우리는 하늘을 통해서 봤습니다. 중국 공항에 대공항을 공항 것들이 중국 정부가 저들이 끌려가는 중국 것을 뿐이 아니어서도 정말 진실처럼 부자리하게 잡아가고 한민의 가족도 그렇게 진실 가족들 개처럼 중국을 앞당하는 사람들 잡아가는 것을 우리는 똑똑히 봤습니다.
Through TV and on film, we saw what the Chinese security agents did to these seven, violently arresting them and repatriating them. Same thing that happened to the Hanmi family, shooting them like animals, worse than animals, like dogs.
저는 중국에서 북한에서 16년 동안 군복무를 하면서 정말 서러운 사람 중에 가장 대표적으로 서러웠다고 생각했습니다. 그리고 북한을 탈출해서 중국에 와서 중국의 국경 도시, 북한과 유명한 국경 도시의 작은 국경 도시에서 사람들이 풍요롭고 자유롭고 정말 그 과일 하나도 마음대로 먹지 못하는 북한을 위해서 과일이 놀려있고 사탕 갖다가 놀려있는 것을 보고 그 한순간에 아, 나는 서봤구나, 서가 살아왔구나, 이렇게 없었고 중국은 우리가 북한에서 대하는 것보다 정말 좋은 나라, 살기 좋은 나라, 참 좋은 나라라고 생각했었던 것 같습니다.
I was in the military for well over a decade in North Korea, and I am a prime example of one who was completely fooled by the regime in North Korea. And when I crossed over to North Korea and glimpsed the life of even just the border city of China, I saw how well off they were, how they were so prosperous and well off compared to the like fellow North Koreans who did not even have enough food to eat. And I realized that China, at that moment, in an instant, I realized that it was so much a better place than North Korea where I came from.
그런 중국이, 그렇게 살기 좋아하고 있는 중국이 왜 김정은과 같은, 김정은 독재정부와 같은 작은 북한에, 권한권을 북한에 아부를 끌고 그렇게 짐승 같은 행동을 하는지 정말 지금도 이해할 수가 없습니다.
And what I can't understand is why China that is prosperous and so much bigger and better than North Korea is kowtowing and groveling at the feet of North Korea and continuing its behavior. That is something that I cannot understand.
저도 중국에 왔다가 중국 공안당국에 체포돼서 북한으로 끌려갔던 적이 있는데 그 사람들이 이런 말을 했습니다. 내가 끌려가면 인민군 장교였으니까 우리 중국도 다 안다. 하지만 중국은 우리 중국 정부는 난민 협박 같은 걸 인정하지 않는다. 난민을 인정하지 않는다. 라고 하면서 정말 웃으면서 살기찬 미소를 띄우면서 저를 포함한 탈북자들을 강제 구속하던 것 지금도 정말 잊혀지지 않습니다.
I shall never forget the moment when I was in China and was arrested and forcibly repatriated. And the border guards, knowing that I was a former elite officer, a member of the elite, officer in the military, they said with a smile on their face that we know what's going to happen to you when you are sent back to North Korea, you are going to be executed. But we in China, we don't recognize and we don't honor international laws regarding refugees and we don't recognize you people as refugees. And I still remember that very vividly.
그렇게 끌려가서 살아서 돌아오지 못한 탈북자들이 천 명도 되고 만 명도 되고 있습니다. 그보다 인간의 생명이 가장 전신시대에야 할 21세기에 중국은 지금 이 순간도 수많은 탈북자들 죽을 줄 알면서 북한으로 강제 구속하고 있습니다.
And there are thousands, perhaps tens of thousands of North Korean refugees who were led away to their deaths like that. And to this day, in this day and age, 21st century, when human lives should be valued, the killing and the sentencing of death of North Korean refugees, North Korean people continues to this day.
김정은이가 야합에서 북한을 죽지 가실 수 있다는 정치적 작은 목적은 달성할 수 있겠으나 사람을 죽이는 인간의 생명을 파기목숨보다 더 가벼운 여기는 중국의 무단한 행위, 인위에 고발되고 역사에 고발되리라고 확신합니다. 중국 정부는 더 이상 김정일 정권과 야합에서 북한의 무고한 동포들을 학살하는 학살 행위를 저지르지 말아야 할 것입니다.
I cannot understand the Chinese government's continued policy of repatriation and sending North Koreans to their deaths. And I implore the Chinese government to stop this genocide, of the North Korean refugees.
제 울분에 넘치는 터지는 마음을 여러분과 함께하는 구호로 거기 쳐보겠습니다. 중국 정부는 김정희가 야바요. 더 이상 탈북자들이 강제 북송을 하지 말라! 하지 말라! 하지 말라!
하지 말라!
감사합니다.
Thank you.
Kim Hae-suk, she also suffered horribly in China. They wanted to be here on behalf of those that are still suffering back, especially the refugees in China.
I truly want to thank everybody for coming out to this special event, this protest, not only in Korea and all over the world, but also especially here in Washington, D.C. And as a defector, I want to express my deepest gratitude for all of you here today.
저는 탈북자의 한 사람으로서 중국 정부가 정말 지구상에서 그래도 동남아에선 가장 대국이라고 부르짖는 중국이 어떻게 이렇게 졸렬한 방법으로 탈북자들을 북송하는지 정말 너무 가슴이 터져옵니다.
And my heart breaks and is filled with anger when I think about how the Chinese government, which claims to be a superpower in the world and especially in the region, as a defector, I cannot fathom why China continues this policy of forced repatriation.
탈북자들이 생존을 위해서 중국에 갑니다. 가면 정말 인류를 사랑한다면 제도를 쳐다 떠나서 인간의 양심으로서 인류를 말살 유린과 죽음으로 몰아가는 일은 중단해야 된다고 생각합니다.
North Korean defectors go to China for survival, and apart from policy or official line of the government, for the love of humanity, if there's any love for humanity, the Chinese government should stop its current policy of forced repatriation.
설사 난민보호국은 아니라고 할 텐데 54개 소수민족과 37개 성을 갖고 있는 중국이 탈북 난민들을 소부지대나 모든 일자리를 창출할 수 있는데도 불구하고 그들을 죽음으로 몰아내는 일은 다시는 엮어지지 말아야 될 것입니다.
I believe that China, with its own numerous ethnic minorities and many opportunities for jobs for the defectors, the refugees that come over to work in, there's so many opportunities for the refugees to not be, there's other choice besides being repatriated.
북한에서 탈출한 사람들은 이념 탈출은 거의 없습니다. 다만 배가 고파서 중국 땅을 밟습니다. 그런데도 불구하고 그들을 북송하게 되면 집결소, 노동 단련대, 가혹하게 죽음으로 몰아냈습니다.
And most of the refugees that come over from North Korea to China, it's not a flight of ideology, but rather a flight of hunger because they're starving as they come over. Yet when they're repatriated, they're sent to detention centers. Prison camps, jail where they are treated horribly.
정말 적세를 치어서 도망감을 건너는 계열도 봤습니다. 너무나 정말 가슴이 아프고 눈물 없이는 볼 수 없는 그런 상황에 저는 제 가슴을 토령해서 전율케 만들어졌습니다.
And I've seen the ashes of China that caused me to be filled with tears in terms of how they treated the refugees that came over from North Korea.
이렇게 죽이고 저렇게 죽이고 정말 인류의 평화를 사랑하는 전 세계 지구촌 어디나 다 우리 인민들은 잘 살아야 됩니다. 그런데 어떻게 북한에 정말 배가 고파서 죽음장을 보내놓은 우리 동포들을 그렇게 무지막지하게 사육장으로 내몰 수 있습니까?
How can China send people to their deaths like this?
정말 우리 탈북자들은 정말 중국 정부에 용서가 되지 않습니다.
And us defectors, we cannot forgive the Chinese government.
오늘 이 시간 이후부터라도 수많은 탈북자들을 중국에 체류하고 있는 탈북자들은 한 명도 독성아리 말아줄 것을 중국 정부에 단호히 강요합니다.
And we firmly demand that the Chinese government will stop this very moment the forced repatriation of North Korean refugees from China back to North Korea.
숨겨주십시오, 탈북자들을 살려주십시오.
Hide them and save them.
정말 중국 정부에 강력히 제기하는데 우리 탈북자들을 한 명이라도 독송하게 된 국세 재판소 앞에 머리 숙일 그날이 반드시 온다는 걸 인정하십시오.
I warn you, Chinese government, that if you continue this policy of forced repatriation, there will come a day when you, the Chinese government, will stand before the International Criminal Court with your head hung low in shame.
배고파 죽고, 부들려라 죽고, 이래서야 되겠습니까?
When they are starved, when they are sent to their deaths, how can this be? How can this continue?
정말 우리 탈북 정부도 다 살라고 이 세상에 태어났습니다. 반드시 중국 정부는 바로 이 시간부터 중단하고 탈북자들을 숨겨주고 가려주고 나만의 전 세계 디아스포라가 되도록 저분이 보내주십시오.
And I demand that the Chinese government, instead of sending them back to North Korea, will send the North Korean refugees to freedom, to countries of freedom, right this moment.
제가 코 한마디 드리겠습니다. 중국 정부는 탈북자 북송을 당장 중단하라!
중단하라!
이상입니다.
Thank you.
Our next speaker is part of the delegation that came and testified in Congress. She is the longest serving survivor of the North Korean prison camp. She was held for 28 years from the time teenager. When she finally escaped North Korea and got to China, she became a victim of the traffickers there, sold four times. Having been through all these horrors in North Korea, she had experienced even more horrors in China. She has been a wonderful witness this week, raising awareness of these horrible things happening to North Korean people and the North Korean refugees. This is Kim Hae-sung. Hello, I'm a survivor of a political prison camp where I was held for 28 years, where I lost my youth, my family, and after release, having crossed over to North Korea, became a victim myself of trafficking in China.
정말 죽음을 각오하고 조국으로도 왔다가 이제 북송되면 어떻게 대해야 된다는 것은 물거진도 못한 사실이므로 중국의 당국자들은 우리 탈북자들을 무조건 강제 북송해서 그들에게 죽음을 안겨주고 있습니다.
I crossed over to China facing death and knowing what would happen to us refugees. I crossed, and yet the Chinese government, knowing what will happen when the refugees are repatriated, continues to send them to their deaths through forced repatriation.
김정일 정부는 인민들이 수많은 인민들을 굶겨죽이기도 앞으로 정수를 못차리고 3대 진습을 추구하면서 북한이 수많은 인민들을 굶겨죽고 때려 죽이고 총으로 쏴 죽이고 수많은 인민들을 하염없이 죽이고 있습니다.
And the regime of Kim Jong-il still it has starved millions and it still has not learned from its past mistakes and continues to kill its own people via execution and starvation and other deprivations in North Korea.
방역자들은 지금 살길을 찾아서 넘어왔던 탈북자들을 제발 더 이상 북송시키지 말아야 하며 우리 탈북자들을 숨겨주어서 그들에게 더 자유의 삶을 줘야 한다고 저는 생각합니다.
I firmly believe that the forced repatriation of broken records must stop and that they must be shown the way to freedom, not to their death.
제가 이제 더 이상 살아있는 그 날까지 제가 이런 당국자들과 정말 이 세상에 어느 세상에 가발함으로써 저 중국의 당국자들이 이 세상에 물이 물고 살아남지 못하도록 저 북한 당국자들 특히 김정은 세습을 반대하는 투쟁에 제일 정말 살아있는 목숨을 다 바쳐서 끝까지 투쟁함으로써 우리 탈북자들이 더는 북송되지 않아서 우리 한국의 한국으로 올 수 있게끔 자유의 삶을 찾아서 정말 그들에게도 자유의 삶을 줘야 한다고 저는 생각합니다.
I don't know how much longer I will live, but until my last dying breath, I will be a witness to the world of the atrocities committed not only by Kim Jong-il and the regime and the third generation succession that will continue the misery, but also of the cruel policy of the Chinese government. And that is what I will do.
정말 제 심장속으로 외치는 구호 한마디를 외치겠습니다. 중국 당국자들은 이제부터라도 북한의 탈북자들을 강제 북송하지 말라!
하지 말라! 하지 말라! 하지 말라!
이상입니다.
most active defectors in the United States, and she was in New York yesterday testifying at a summit sponsored by UN Watch. She's been a very passionate advocate, even though she's safely been able to resettle here in the United States. Her son, her husband, and Mrs. Ma Young-ae have continued to work passionately for the people of North Korea. And she has a musical group that she's taken all around the country to different churches to educate the Korean American community here about what's happening in North Korea. It's a great honor to introduce Ma Young-ae. She's our last defector speaker.
안녕하십니까. 이 자리에는 우리 한국에서 우리 탈북자 대표들이 들어왔고 또 미국에 있는 인권단체 임원들과 또 수자 셜티 디펜스 포럼의 수자 셜티 이 행사를 주관하고 있습니다.
Hello, good afternoon. Today we have very special guests, working directors from South Korea, and also human rights, working human rights groups from the U.S. Sudan Shulti, Ms. Sudan Shulti's group is here also.
저는 어제 뉴욕에서 진행되는 23개 인권단체가 모인 국제인권모임에 제가 초청이 돼서 북한의 인권 상황을 고발하는
And yesterday, in light of the UN summit that was happening, another NGO, UN Watch, hosted a conference to highlight the persecution of people around the world. And I was invited by UN Watch while the UN summit was going on to speak about the human rights situation in North Korea.
제가 어제 진행한 기본 내용에는 그 북한을 탈출하게 된 내용과 함께 또 제가 탈출한 이후에 북한 가족에서 일어난 문제들이 질문으로 들어왔고 그리고 현재 미국에서 활동하고 있는 이런 상황들에 대해서 제가 질문을 받고 거기에 답하는 그런 증언이 있었습니다.
And this event for me was where I spoke about why I escaped North Korea and what activities I'm doing now in the U.S. During the Q&A session.
저는 북한을 탈출하게 된 것이 종교 탄압과 및 정치적인 탄압으로 제가 북한을 탈출하게 되었습니다.
And the two main reasons why I stayed in North Korea were for political persecution and also for religious persecution reasons.
물론 많은 여기에 탈북하신 분들이 마음속에 원한이 있습니다. 저는 북한에서 제가 탈출 이후에 미국에서 인권 활동을 했다는 이유로 저희 남편을 김정일 독재자가 처형을 했습니다.
My situation is one where after I escaped North Korea because of my activities for human rights issues in, of North Korea, my husband was left behind in North Korea and was executed.
제가 오늘 여러분들 앞에 탈출한 후에 제가 미국에서 김정일의 암살수사 북한의 공개처형 및 북한 정치범 수용소 및 북군 포로병들에 대한 그런 증언들을 각 교회와 함께 인권단체들 그리고 사회단체들의 초청으로 제가 하게 되었는데 그때 유엔 대표국 박기련 대사가 저희 신원여행을 평양에 가는 것이 뉴욕 한국일보에 났었습니다.
And in one of my activities for human rights situation in North Korea, while I went around different churches and organizations speaking about human rights issues, political prison camps, the religious persecution, and the abject issue, my activity was reported in the Korean, the local Korean newspaper.
그 이후에 북한 정부로부터 이제 수많이 공격을 협박도 받았고 작년 3월달에는 북한 대표부 앞에서 신선호 대사와의 그 지금 대모를 하고 그 앞에서 대모를 하고 있는데 직접 쌍깐까지 죽여버리겠다는 그런 미국에서 그것도 뉴욕 터에서